Hello everyone. Welcome to Automobile Engineering class. I am B. Rakesh, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department. In this session, I am going to explain starting system in an automobile. Starting system works with the help of starting motor or cranking motor. It is used to start heavy engines which cannot be started by hand cranking. IC engines are required to be rotated at some minimum speed after which the engine start running by fuel supply. This initial rotation is given by the starting motor, and this is the function of starting motor. The starting system is a combination of mechanical and electrical parts that work together to start the engine. The starting system is designed to convert electrical energy from the battery into mechanical energy in the starting motor. This motor then transfer the mechanical energy through gears to the flywheel and the engine crankshaft. The starting system consists of the following parts: battery, ignition switch, magnetic switch. This switch is available in either an electrical relay or a solenoid. Starter motor, safety switch. You can see these parts in this figure. This is the battery, this is the ignition switch, this magnetic switch is available in solenoid or relay control, this is the safety switch, this is the starter motor, this is the drive pinion, this is the flywheel. The entire system is divided into two circuits. One is starter circuit, another one is control circuit. The starter circuit carries the heavy current from the battery to the starter motor through a magnetic switch in a relay or solenoid. Second circuit is control circuit. The control circuit connects the battery power at the ignition switch to the magnetic switch, which control the high current to the starter motor. Let us see the working of starting system. When the ignition switch is moved to start position, that means when cranking is done, the starter solenoid contained within the starter operates moving the starter drive, that means pinion gear, to a position where it can engage with a ring gear on the outside of a flywheel or torque converter in case of automobile transmission. The starter motor will also begin rotating at this time, and the drive gear means pinion gear, which is in contact with the ring gear of flywheel, forces it to rotate. As the flywheel rotates, the air fuel mixture is drawn into the cylinder, compressed and ignited to start the engine. It may be noted that on models with automatic transmission, a neutral start safety switch prevents the starting with the transmission in gear, and on some models with manual transmission, a clutch safety switch prevents starting unless the clutch is fully pressed. The starter motor is a special type of direct drive motor which produces an extremely high output. However, due to its design, the starter can only operate for a short period of time. The operation of starter The operation of starter motor also results in the considerable amount of heat generation, and continuous operation can cause burning of the motor. The starter should never be operated for more than 30 seconds at a time and should rest for about 2 minutes before it is restarted so that the heat may be dissipated. When the engine has been started successfully and begin to rotate at a faster speed than starter motor, an overrunning clutch operates and drive gear begins to freewheel. Thus, the drive force generated by the engine will not be transmitted to the starter. When the ignition switch is returned to on position, the flow of current to the starter will be stopped. This causes the drive gear, that means pinion gear, to return to its original position. The starter motor also stops rotating at this time. This is the working of starting system. Let us see the summary of starting system. In early days of automobile, the vehicles did not have a starter motor. The operator or driver had to use a cranking lever or handle to turn the engine by hand. By using starting system in vehicles instead of cranking lever, the physical effort required on part of driver is eliminated, and also the driver is not required to get out of the vehicle each time the vehicle needs to be started. In starting system circuit, the relay controls the current flow to the solenoid, which in turn control the current flow to the starter motor. This reduces the amount of current flow through the ignition switch. This is the brief discussion about starting system. In next lecture, we will going to discuss overrunning clutch and working of overrunning clutch or solenoid. Thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates.